cat people, how are you today? I am Cat Lady and the Honey, and today we are doing a body paint. So, what we are doing today? As you have probably already noticed, there is a series on my Instagram page, which is Cat Lady and the Honey, my Instagram page. And yeah, I have a series about Disney princesses or villains. And a lot of you asked me to try to make a short tutorial, like a reel on Instagram or stuff like that, how I'm doing the body paint. So I decided to go big and do a whole video. Of course, I'm not gonna dye my hair black because I do not really like black hair on me. For other people are definitely okay, but not for me, it's not my color. But beyond that, I will do the body paint and a very nice princessy face makeup. So if you're ready for that, let's start. The first step here is to draw some lines to know where the dress is gonna be, where the sleeves are gonna be, where I'm gonna put the colors and stuff like that. For this reason, I'm gonna use two pencils, eye pencils I guess. This one is from NYX, the shade white. And the other one, the more thin one, it's this one right here. It's so tiny, so I do not really remember where I bought it from, but it doesn't really matter. Let's do it! Here we have the lines finished. I'm gonna explain you a little bit what I have done here. This is something extra. It's not the original version of Snow White's dress, but I'm thinking that I want some red elements because he originally has a red ribbon and I'm not sure if I have a red ribbon. So I'm planning to make this red to make something like a ribbon design or something like that. This is gonna be dark blue and the sleeves are gonna be lighter blue. So for the dark blue I'm gonna use from my palette here, from Mehron Makeup, the shade dark blue, which is this one right here. I don't know if you can see it. Yes. And for my sleeves, which are gonna be lighter blue, I'm gonna use from Eulenspiegel, or whatever is the correct pronunciation. I'm sorry, I don't know German. So I'm gonna use this for the sleeves. And this is called face paint. Yeah, I know that this is face paint, but you do not have a name on it. Anyway, this is the face paint that I'm gonna use. I'm taking pure water, like that. The bottle that I keep my pure water is from a serum or primer that I used to have, but nowadays it contains only water. I washed it and I used it for water because it has this drop thing that helps me a lot. And I'm gonna put some drops on blue. I don't have a lot of blue in my palette, so I don't wanna overdo it with the water. Yeah, I know it took a lot, but I finished it and now I'm going to the sleeves. Again, I'm gonna use this no-name shade from Eulenspiegel and I'm gonna add some water, as I always do. And I'm gonna take a detail brush, like not super detail of course, but something like that, because I'm kinda scared to go with a fluffy brush because I want to make sure that I will have the details here to make them red. And maybe I will enhance it with some blue if I don't like the shade in the end. We will see, we will see. Now all the blue parts are done and I'm moving on to red. I'm gonna use from Mehron palette, this one right here, the shade red, which is basically this red right here. I know that you might think that this is a very dark red, but it's not, it's very normal. So what I'm gonna do is that I will fill this area here and this, I don't know how to describe this shape, okay? So anyway, this and this will be red. the lights of the main dress is here. And now I'm gonna do the black parts, aka the shades, and I'm trying to do it kind of more cartoonish and not as realistic as the other ones. So for this reason, I'm gonna use from Revolution the bright palette, and from this palette I'm gonna use the black. It's oil color, so this will make the whole dress having another kind of dimension and 3D effect and stuff like that. You will see it. Of course, nothing has finished yet, but now we have a basic form of the shadows. I'm trying to fix a little bit the knot here, and for this I'm gonna use from You Can Be and the palette Athena here, the white, here. I was looking for a name, but unfortunately it does not have a name. Anyway, is this palette this white? It's unique, you're not gonna be confused. And with a tiny, tiny brush, I will go to the center of the knot and I will try to add some lights. So, center and a little bit up, like here. Yes, exactly. And of course, I'm gonna blend the light that I have added, make it more 3D. And now that I have finished with the basic forms of the lines and the shadows and all this stuff, I'm gonna go with this palette. This is the collaboration that Morphe did with James Charles. So I'm gonna take the blackest black here, which is this shadow. I'm gonna find the name and I will tell it to you. Give me a second, because I'm trying not to confuse myself. It's spooky. The black is called Spooky, and with a clean brush I will go here wherever I have the black basically, and I will try to put some extra shade and blend it better into the blue and create more dimension in general. I'm gonna start by these lines, which are the most, you know, pale, and then I will go to the rest of the dress. So I finished with the light and the shades, and I've done some details at the sleeves in order to make them a little bit more 3D. And my last step is to add some kind of beige eyeshadow here around the black line to make the transition more smooth. Like, I don't prefer to be black and then to be my skin, so I want to make some fade out, I would say. For this purpose, I'm gonna use one of my favorite palettes, apparently. Oh my god! What happened? The whole eyeshadow left me! People, the whole eyeshadow left me from here! Look at it! People, are you interested to see a video how I'm fixing this kind of accidents? Like how I will smash the shadow and then put it back and then press it again? I've done short Instagram stories, videos, something like that anyway, but I have done nothing here on YouTube, so please, if you're interested, write a comment down below. As I was saying, I'm gonna use from this palette the shade Culada here, and I'm gonna add some extra shadows around the black. I'm gonna take a brush like that. This is from Morphe E62. I want a kind of white brush, but not a face brush or something. I feel that at this point I have pretty much finished with the body paint, and now I'm going to do my face makeup. And mainly I'm gonna use this palette because I'm thinking to do a very, very nice kind of everyday look, because Snow White wasn't that extra of a character. So yeah, I'm gonna keep it cool tone, like earth tone. So let's go to see the face makeup. I have already primed my eyes with primer potion right here, and with a kind of fluffy brush. This is from NYX 16. I'm gonna start using the shredded eyeshadow here to create a base. So I'm gonna put it on my lid. Again, I do not want anything extra, to be honest. Then with the shade, I don't know, maybe this one, Lovely Bunch here, I'm gonna go to my crease and give some depth. So I'm taking an angled brush, this one right here. I don't think that this brush has a name on it because it's kind of old. And if I want more depth, I might go with Natty, this brownish shade right here. With this small brush from Morphe M124, I'm gonna go here at the shade Natty, and then I will just give a little bit of extra depth here at the corner of my eyes. Okay, now let's go to the interesting part again, which is the glitter. So for that, I'm gonna use this stick for the first time. This is from e.l.f., the rose gold, because I wanna give that extra touch. And of course, I'm not leaving something just neutral, you know? So I don't know how to use it, really. Like, if it's okay to put it on top of... what's the name? Powder shadows, anyway. And I'm gonna just put it on my lid. Yeah, it makes a difference. Like, it's exactly what I wanted. It makes a difference, but it's so slight and gentle as a color. Just give some extra sparkle. Oh, that's very nice. Yeah, I'm very, very happy with it. If you can see the difference between the eyes, I don't know if you can see it clearly now, but yeah, so good. I'm thinking that I will put some extra. I don't know if I wanna put a topper on it or if I'm gonna leave it as it is. I added some eye pencil. This is Spiffy from Morphe. And then at the bottom part of my eyes, I used again Natty here. And then I faded it out into Colada to make a smooth transition. And now I'm gonna use a mix of Palm Reader here and Coco Crush here for my inner corner and for the eye under the eyebrow area. I'm gonna start with Coco Crush to see how intense it is, and then I will decide how much of the white I wanna use. Yeah, I need to use a lot. I have put my fake lashes, and also I have finished with my face base, aka I have used the putty primer from e.l.f., which is about to finish, so you will not see it in a lot more videos now. My favorite foundation, bear with me, and before that step, I actually used the corrector from Charlotte Tilbury. Very good one, very good, totally recommend it. And also, I have done some eyeliner here. I don't know if you can see it. This is, as always, and this is not gonna change soon, my favorite one from NYX Professional Makeup, the Epic Ink Eyeliner in black. I have used other type of eyeliners, but this specific one with hair here at the brush, and not just a sponge, it helps me a lot, and I feel it makes the whole experience more smooth and the line more thin. I don't know, I like it so much, as you probably understood. So this is my third or fourth one. I have already finished the others, and now I will apply some concealer, and then I will go to the blush part. Oh, this is the product from my brows. We're not applying this right now at this step. Anyway, I'm gonna find my concealer. I'm gonna apply the concealer, and then on the top, of course, out of the top of the concealer, on my cheeks, I will apply this blush, which is from MUA, and it's in the shade Watermelon, a very, very nice red one. And I feel that it fits perfectly the concept because at the fairy tale Snow White has very nice and blushed cheeks. So this is gonna be it for today. Let's see it! Okay, I finished with the blush. Yes, it's a little bit intense, but that was the purpose. Like, Snow White was like 14, so it's a really young girl, very happy, full of life, and I wanted to have this in my makeup. That's why I'm not planning to do any contouring or bronzing, because I want to give that youngish feeling. And now, as a highlighter, I'm gonna use only from Fenty Beauty How Many Carats, because it's a very very nice icy glittery white, and that's the shine that I wanna give to my Snow White. Like, I'm so impressed every time that I've used this one, although that I already have used it like 1,000 times. Like, it's so good. I'm gonna add some powder to the rest of my face, and for this I'm gonna use the Cloud Set Breezy from Kosas. This is a gift from my friend Afroditi. Hello, Afroditi. And I really liked it. Really, really like it. I don't know if it is to have it for all day and remain free of greasiness, but for these types of makeup that I actually am not planning to go out and be a little Snow White doing shopping. Although that this is, might be a nice idea for a future video. Do you want to see me going out in a body paint and see how people will react? Anyway, this is not for now, so I'm gonna use it, and I have a very very nice glow on my face. And now, before I do my lips, I decide that it's time for the Greek word of the day. So, I'm doing Snow White, and I'm not gonna tell you the word for Snow White because it's pretty much useless. But instead, I'm thinking to tell you the word for snow. So, in Greek, we say χιόνι. Say with me, χιόνι. So that's it, that's the word for today. Try to be creative down at the comments, use that word, and who knows, maybe your comment will be in one of my next videos. Lips time! And for that, I'm gonna use from Colourpop the Jubilee lip liner, and I'm gonna line my lips. On the top of that, I'm gonna add this liquid lipstick from Sunkissed. And it's the shade, oh come on, why is it so difficult to find the shade? Cherry red, that's the shade. And it's the perfect red for Snow White, because it's not too dark, but it's very nice and vibrant, and it smells like cherry. Very important factor, people. To be honest, I don't know if at the original film Snow White had something like a gloss on her lips, but to me it matches the character since she's a young girl. So for this reason, I'm gonna use from Udensai Elva, which is a lip stain, but I feel that it kinda can work as a lip gloss because it's a very nice liquidy color. You will see it now. So here we have it. Look at the packaging. Like, I'm dying for this packaging. And is this color? Of course, we cannot finish a makeup without setting spray, so for this reason I'm gonna use from W7 Matte Fixer. And I'm gonna seal the result with Niki Tutorials Fun. Very very carefully, because I don't want any kind of spray or liquid on my body. At least not a big amount. And that's it for today. I hope that you enjoyed the body paint, and actually I hope that I brought a little bit of nostalgia in your life by reminding you the older Disney movies and the older characters. Actually, are you a fan of the older Disney movies or the newer ones? Write down in the comments, I'm so interested to learn. Personally, I prefer both. If you want to see more of Disney makeup, you can always visit my Instagram page, which is gonna be CatLadyAndIgoni, somewhere around here, where I have done more princesses and villains. Also, if you want to see some other body paints here in this channel, you can click at my older videos, and I have two more for now, because I'm planning to do more. So if you want to make sure that you are not going to miss anything, subscribe to my channel and ring the bell to be among the first people that receive a notification when I have a new video. Thank you so, so much for being here with me today. Until next time, bye bye!